No?
Hard scootum, clean up! Hard scootum, clean up! Concept skitte! Adassium!
Ladies and gentlemen, that is how you enter a battlefield. Not bumbling around, not wandering around going, ooh, what am I doing? You know what you are doing. You are a professional army. Ladies and gentlemen, we are the Roman. I am the centurion Diocletian. We are the greatest professional army in the world. You've seen people playing with weapons. You now see the professionals. Intente! Laxate. The Roman army is built on three sound principles. The three sound principles that our entire culture are built on. The three sound principles that really you should be considering when you make your vote. The Roman army is built on discipline. Everybody working together as a team. It has the highest standards of equipment. Everybody is issued with the highest standards of equipment. Not just the ones who can afford it. Everybody. And it's built on tactics. And when I say tactics, I mean a complete range of tactics. Not simply, let's run at the enemy, let's run away from the enemy, let's run at the enemy, let's run away. Real tactics. This is how the Roman army works. And I will demonstrate this for you now. Intente! Intra! Duos passos clina! Sinistorum vertite clina! Retrostorum vertite clina! Sinistorum vertite clina! Intente! Laxate! Intente! Laxate! Everybody working together. You see it today. And that's what our whole society is built on. Teamwork. Working together. You don't have a 400-year head for this. You can't work together as a team. You can't change and adapt and learn new ways of doing things. That's what the Roman army is built on. How our discipline is really key, how we can all work together. Absignus! Not so fast, Severus Claudius. Absignus. Severus Claudius. Front and centre. Intente! Two types of soldier that I'm showing you here. This is Severus, a legionary soldier in the Roman army, 10 years service. 10 years of fighting around the world. Training, real training. Not sitting around picking fluff out of his belly button. Real training. Working hard. Fighting across an empire to protect families and people's rights. Not going around raiding other tribes, taking slaves, killing them, taking their cattle, protecting people's lives. This is the blueprint for a police force. There's a reason why the riot police use the tactics they use to protect you. There's a reason why they wear the similar equipment to this guy here. It's designed to take on a bunch of ill-disciplined thugs. And that's exactly what we end up facing. Ill-disciplined thugs. Over here, we have Claudius. Claudius is an auxiliary soldier. Well, now, unlike Severus, who is a citizen of the Roman Empire, Claudius is not. He comes from a people who joined them. So that means, as with any good society, you earn your way into it. So he does so by becoming an auxiliary soldier. And by serving in the Roman army, he is a citizen, and all his family are. And they are treated equally to everyone else, because the citizens' rights are not made up, they are recorded, written, and adhered to. We have a legal system. Not a chieftain making all the decisions. We have a correct You look at the pieces of equipment they've got. We start at the top. Every Roman soldier, not a just the chieftain, every Roman soldier has a helmet. The style worn here by Severus as a legionary is what we call the Gallic style. It was first encountered by fighting against the Gauls. See an idea? It works really well. We respect the idea, we welcome the Gauls in, and we develop that equipment to fit with our own. You can see the helmet here is a sound base. The cheek flaps to protect the sides, only a small part of his face is showing. The ears are protected, but they're left open, so you can still hear and work together with the commands, which are fundamental, the discipline you just talked about. The piece at the back protects his neck and sits over the top of the armour there. We have a similar style here, again, slight variation from what Claudius is wearing. There was one particular very tight. We'll keep using helmets while they are useful. But we'll keep adapting them and changing them to try and bring out the newest one so that the Roman army is always developing, always thinking. The Lorica armour, classic Roman armour worn by the legionary soldier. Entirely a Roman design. Mass produced so that every legionary soldier, the core of our army, are wearing this. We're not just going to have it handed out to the ones who are the most important. Everybody gets it. It's flexible. It's easy to repair. It moves easily. Most of the opponents we fight against use big, long slashing swords. They like to lock forwards and aim a strike down. It just runs down. It's articulated to stay across the shoulders. It's like American football. Will bounce off, does no harm at all. Supreme protection, every legionary soldier wears one of those. Chainmail worn by Claudius here allows more flexibility. Whilst the legionary soldier is the front and centre of our army, we have auxiliaries usually on the flanks on the side to protect. That's why when somebody does come rushing out of the out of nowhere, you have your mobilised units on the side that can take the initial turn. Every strength has a potential to use. The strength of these guys at front means that, yeah, we could be attacked on the side. Yes. We are Romans. We have auxiliary units. We adapt and we change and we will overcome opponents. I tell you, you go along. Scutum, the shield. This is the key point. You've heard a lot about shields. This is a shield. This is made out of three pieces of wood glued together. Totally solid. You remember the demonstration earlier on? What they neglected to mention, when their champion sword landed in the middle, it got stuck in the shield. Not much use for fighting with them, is it? Celtic sword never have taken for granted. Not much use in the fight after the initial contact. They're not made for long battles. The shield wall gives us total protection at the front. The scutum can be used to block, but can also be used to barge and to strike. Not a punching with, but a level strike or a strike down at the feet. All of which are very, very effective. The oval shield, used by the auxiliary again, allows us exactly the same advantages that the Celtic shields do. But it also allows our soldiers the manoeuvrability to protect our flanks. And everyone gets them to that highest standard. Not just the people who've got on the table. Pilum, a javelin. Every legionary carries two of these. Javelin is launched as the enemy run towards us. The long thin piece will strike through enemy shields, break through to the other side and hit somebody. It also bends on impact, a bit like that way, the shield is rendered useless before they even get to it. If it sticks into you, it's going to hurt going in. Once it's bent in and you're pulling it out, it's going to hurt even more coming back out. These are serious weapons, mass produced so that everybody gets it to the highest standard. The hastar, the spear used by our auxiliary soldiers, great for cutting off cavalry, allowing people to have some distance. Nobody wants to run against the wood spears when they've got that kind of solid shield with them. Good protection for our sides, allowing us the maneuverability to develop and adapt our tactics based on who we face in front of us. Gladius Stringite! The Gladius sword. Where we get the name Gladiator from. These are short swords. that are designed for use behind the large shield. What happens is when you've got a shield wall, people are all pushed together. So the sword, again, made to the highest standard, is used to stab against your enemy. And on a final point on equipment, Caligae. 2 foot. I don't think they'll have mentioned those.
They haven't got very good ones.
Roman shoes have got studs. No other ancient people have studs on the base of their shoes. Like football boots, they give you grip. So when people come running into you, you have a solid base and they just fall over. Slipping and sliding around. Footwork, solid foundation, is the basis for any good soldier. Funnily enough, it's also the basis for any good civilization. One that might last, say, I don't know, 400 years. Serious equipment. Abs ignis, full length. Oh, hang on. Take these away.
Cletian, this auxiliary has been playing up in the ranks.
Been playing up? In what ways have been playing up, Severus?
Just moaning and complaining as always, Centurion.
Well, it sounds like you've got a bit of tension there, so let's get it out. Come on, you two. Have a little bit of a... Here we go, Happy. We watch the fighting style of these soldiers now. Fight! Closer, speak, Jay! Halt! Intente! You see, compact fighting. Short movements are key, they're essential to what a Roman soldier does. It is intelligent fighting. Abs ignis volet. We talk about the equipment. The other thing we talk about are tactics. It brings a smile to your face.
And then,
very brave, that is, isn't it? Very honourable, that is.
Something doesn't quite match up there.
Adassian! Vincente! Yeah, we have to develop our tactics for suitable situations. As you've seen, it is important that we can move long distances. So to do that, we will develop some important tactics. It allows us to move across the field, not running around, getting scared. This is where, if you do get attacked, and Aganin! Prosite! Take! Agadiam Clina! Agadiam Clina! I'm glad you're clean up! Conches, Tite! Working as one unit. Adassian! In no time at all, we've switched to a battle formation. And this is the simple principle that the Roman army works from. We have a strong, solid line, with the strength of the legionary soldier in the middle, and the versatility of our auxiliaries on the edges. And people may say that we don't change our tactics very much. We've already changed them. One, charge. They're going to run into the middle of our line. Gladio stringite! Intente! Mite! 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 Pretty simple, really. They run at you. They break on your shield wall. The shield wall is a fundamental principle developed by the Roman army and used for centuries afterwards by other armies because it's so effective. Not by the Celts. Run into the line, you end up running into what is essentially a meat grinder. Meaty! 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 Now, all of that stabbing and killing people can be quite hard work. You imagine there's a lot of confusion going on. It's all the Celts are in here. Remember, they've got their big long swords. They're all packed in together. They've got their big long spears. They're all packed in together. There's no way to go. In actual fact, what length are packed in is like themselves. They'll take out most of their own side. You've seen that big fella over there. He counts for more injuries in his own arm than he does for anyone else. It's not designed for working as a team. It is designed for working in single combat. Me first. Just about me. Celtic fighting, like Celtic culture, is all about me. I'm the only one. Roman warfare is about us. We, a family of soldiers, stood together. And we can adapt our tactics during the fight to allow our soldiers to progress. Intente! Intra! Yenge! Some of those soldiers are going to be sleeping in bed. We're going to find ways to rotate them in and out.
Let's assume the community.
Mite! Intente!
No hope.
That's what I believe. People are about working together.
There is one more formation that we're going to
Testudo formation. Quite a famous one. No, it's the tortoise as well. Ad testudinum!
So, should we be attacking anyone before
the fight? Once up to the enemy, without risking our own soldiers. Let's attack! Prosite!
Okay, come forward.
Excellent defense for them. Come, Sestite! Retrostorum
Batite! Prosite!
History will tell you which side is the stronger. Come, Sestite! Laxate. Absignus. So ladies and gentlemen, you can see that we're running. But ultimately, the Romano is a solid basis. There's one of the things that we're going to do today. The Roman army trains every single one of its soldiers. However, we have specific troops which are able to do this at the highest standard of the empire. We have different types of that for this use. Armor piercing. Do various types of damage. We even have this one here with a cage on the end of it, so you can put burning
power to his ankles.
The archery is down to the high ground. They can fire 200, 250 meters. You cut it down. That's they've got. Ladies and gentlemen, we've been the Romans. Thank you very much for listening to us. Salute!
Ratus! Ratus! Ratus!
Built on those principles. Ladies and gentlemen, voting will be opening now. The battle here. We will be back. Go and talk to the people in the camp. Thank you very much. And Intente! Rosite! Sin!